Hey guys, welcome back to Colin's number one kitchen. It's been a while, I know, but today we're gonna make my own sort of chicken Kiev that the missus asked for. We got our British chestnut mushrooms to get a nice nutty flavour, our asparagus, our thyme, also gonna use some basil, got a chicken on my left, and some string that my butcher has kindly given to me to tie up the chicken with. So yeah, I'll be right back. Right, I've already sliced the two chicken fillets into halves like this. I'm just gonna season them up, and then we'll put in the cheese. We have some goat's cheese and some ready herbed cheese. I've got my seasoning already. I've actually run out of chicken seasoning, so I'm just gonna have to make my own. But yeah, we'll be right back. I've put on the herb cheese and the goat's cheese, also chopped up some fresh basil, sprinkled some basil. Now I'm going to put some fresh thyme. Now I'm just going to try and tie up the chicken. I think I've done this only once before, so if I did get it a bit wrong, don't worry. Thanks to my butcher for some free string. Tell you guys, this is a bit tricky. Of course. Long the string was. I'm getting it. That's it. It's harder than it looks, people. Sorry about the silence, I'm just trying to concentrate. that's done. And I'll just snip this, tie it off, and voila. Right, 3 chickens, all seasoned, wrapped and tied. Sorry about that, I had to cut the video so I can tie it properly. We're going to chuck this first of all in the oven, half cook it in the oven. And then we're going to grill it on the griddle pan afterwards to get that nice grilled flavour. Now I'm going to move on to the chestnut mushrooms and asparagus and the baby potatoes. So I will be back. Right guys, on to the mushrooms. We have chestnut mushrooms. It's going to give you that nice nutty flavour. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put them on the griddle pan. But I'm not going to add any sort of oil or olive oil or nothing like that. We just want them to grill. Put the heat, I say, fairly medium to high. Obviously count out your portions, amount of, so I'm doing 6 each. And that's all you're going to want to do, you want to leave it like that for at least a minute on each side. And then, well, you go to, depending on your heat. Turning them, eventually seeing how they look, and if you think they're ready, take them off, put on your next look. That's all we're going to do to it, ladies and gentlemen. We're just going to grill it on the griddle pan, take it off, and that's how you're going to eat it. When you wash your mushrooms, this was a piece of advice I got from my missus, don't rinse them under water. Mushrooms contain a lot of water already. Just get yourself a clean piece of kitchen tissue, anything like that, and just rub them down, rub off all the dirt, soil, depending on how fresh you got them, rub off all that soil and dirt, and hey presto, you're good to go. Right, so we'll be back once these are doing. Let's see. Yeah, we're getting there. I'll be right back. As you can see, I've turned over the chestnut mushrooms. This is how you want them to look. If you could smell the way it smells in here right now, how does it smell, Kel?
Good, good, good.
Like what, nuts?
Yes.
It smells very nutty because we're quite nutty. Hey, hey, hey. So we have a nutty mushrooms for nutty people. But no, they smell really nice. Once you turn them, they do produce quite a lot of their water as well coming out from the actual inside. So when you do turn them, you're going to get quite a bit of a splash, a bit of a sizzle. That's totally fine. That also infuses them with their essence and their perfume or the nuts. So yeah. Also, when you do chop your mushrooms, keep the stalks. We're going to blend it up. We're also going to make the sauce from that. We're going to do a mushroom brandy sauce to go with the meal. I'll show you once we get there, so hold on tight. Right, people, I've just taken the chicken out of the oven, put it into the griddle pan. Now we're just going to get that grill mark, get that grill taste. It's going to be good. Like I said before, now we're going to make our sauce. Like I said, keep the mushroom stalks. We've got that in here. We've got some chopped tomatoes, some basil leaves, the all-ground spice, and the garlic and pepper herb seasoning also. And I also put in 2 capfuls of brandy. This is what's going to give you a sort of that sharp taste. So I'm just going to go ahead and blend this up. I'll be right back. I need 2 hands for this. Yeah. Right, we're gonna do the flambé again. So there we go. Stand back.
Yeah.
Right, so you put the brandy, you let the brandy catch up to the fire, and voila. Ooh, that smells good, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Keep that down. Are you pissed off? My little helpers helping to peel the pistachio nuts.
Hello!
Hello! Chop, chop, faster, faster, faster. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Now we are frying up the pistachio nuts. This is going to go nicely with the nut-flavoured mushrooms. They're going to, oh, trust me, it's going to taste good. And here's the sauce. If you could taste that sauce, trust me, man, it's amazing. Is it amazing, Clayton?
Yep.
That's right. Pistachio nuts are frying. Plates are halfway plated up. We're getting there, we're getting there, we're getting there. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to plate up and we'll be right back. Peace. My finished mixed cheese Kiev, chestnut mushrooms with pistachio nuts, baby potatoes cooked in mixed herbs, basil, parsley, coriander, and your asparagus fried in olive oil. Sauce contains brandy, basil, mixed seasoning, mushroom stalks, and a little bit of other, plus the brandy. So here we go. Hope the missus enjoys this. Hope you guys try this. If this video wasn't as good as my last, it was kind of rushed. Everyone's kind of hungry, running kind of late today due to sports day. I was kind of busy. We've got sports day again tomorrow. So, oh yeah, got to make the shakes after this as well. So guys, hope you enjoy this. Hope you try it. Let me know what you think. Enjoy. Bye.